Hello friends, in this video we'll be discussing problem number 3 on Hess diagram. Here we're discussing divisibility problem. Welcome back friends. Let us move on. Let us discuss the third problem on Hess diagram, one of the most important problem, because this type of problem you can expect in the exam. And the question saying, draw the Hess diagram for D42. Now, first of all, what do you mean by D42? D42 means divisors of 42. D42 means divisors of 42. That means we're going to find it out. We're going to check which terms divides 42. 1 divides 42, 2 divides 42, 3 divides 42, 6 divides 42, 7 divides 42, 14, 21 and 42. So these are the elements which divides 42. So therefore, in a set, we're going to consider these elements 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 14, 21, and 42. Now, from this, first of all, we're going to write it on the relation. And how to write it on the relation? In the relation, we're going to consider all the divisibility. That means we're going to check 1 divides which elements? All the elements. So therefore, it will be 1, 1. 1 divides 2, 1 divides 3, 1 divides 6, 1 divides 7, 1 divides 14, 1 divides 21, 1 divides 42. What next? Now 1 is done. Now we're going to consider 2. First of all, 2 divides 2, then 2 divides 6. We're going to write it on the relation in this format. 2 divides 14, 2 divides 42. Next, 3 divides itself. Every element divides itself first of all. Then it will be 6. 3 divides 6. Then 3 divides 21 and 3 divides 42. Next, 6 divides itself. 6 divides 42. 7 divides itself, then 7 divides 14. 14, 14, 14, 42. Next, 21, 21 and 21, 42 and finally 42, 42. So this is your relation based on D42. Here we're going to check all the divisibility. Is this clear? Let us start with the problem. What is the first step? Draw the diagram. So diagram. Now you can pause this video and or you can draw a diagram with me, because it will take time. 1, 2, 3. Next. 6, 7, 14 and 21, 42 and 1. First of all, there will be self loops, because every element divides itself, so there will be self loop. What next? 1 divides every element, so there will be a link from 1 to every other element. What about 2? 2 divides 6, 2 divide 14, 2 divide 42. Next, 3 divides 6, 3 divides 21, 3 divides 42, 6, 6 divides 42. Seven divides 14, seven divides 21, and seven divides 42. Twenty-one also divides 42, and 42 divides 42. So if there is any link missing, so please excuse me for that, and you can please manage by yourself. So this is your digraph. So step number one is done. Now tell me, which is the most difficult step? There are four steps in drawing the Hess diagram. So which is the most difficult step? The next one. Drawing digraph is manageable. The next step is difficult, and that is removing reflexive and transitive edges. Reflexive edges still you can manage, because these circles are your reflexive edges. But removing transitive edges from this particular diagram is a bit difficult. So I'm giving you the trick. If there is a divisibility problem, what you're going to do is, first of all, once you're done with the step number one, directly draw step number four. Directly draw step number four. Once you're done with problem number, step number one, directly draw step number four. That means divisibility. See how to draw step number four. It's very important, because in the next video, we'll be discussing five examples in which divisibility problem. We're going to skip all the steps and we're going to directly draw the result. So concentrate. One divides every element. What next? Two. One divides two. So two will come here. Next, three. Three will come here because there is no relation between 2 and 3. 2 and 3 neither divides each other. 6. 6 will come here because 2 divides 6 as well as 3 divides 6. 7. 7 will come here because 2, 3 and 7, there is no relation. 1 divides 7. 14. 14 will come here because 2 divides 14 and 7 divides 14. 21. 21 will come here because 7 divides 21, 3 divides 21, and finally 42. That's it. So we got a cube here. Is this clear? So what is the first step? You're going to draw the final step. I highly recommend pause this video, go back and check again how I did it. Is this clear? Now from this, we go in a reverse order. This is what this step. What does this step? Step number three is draw the digraph in a such a way that all the edges are pointing upwards. So what we're going to do is one, see here, two, three. Just look this and make this particular diagram. And by looking at this, see here, because what is the last step? From this step, we get this step. And what is the last step saying? Remove the direction. So we remove the direction, replace circle with dot. So from this, you draw this, and from this, you draw this. Means reflexives, removing reflexive and transitive edges. So the order will remain same. Exactly same order of these elements we're going to write on as it is. 1, 2, 3, then 6 here, 7 here, then 14, 21 and 42, 14, 21 and 42. Now, in this particular diagram, which edges will be present? The edges which are present here. So what are the edges present? 1, 2, 3, 7. 1, 2, 3, 7. From 1, it's 2, 3, 7. From 2, it is 6 and 14. 6 and 14. Next. From 3, it is 6 and 21. So 6 and 21. From 7, 14 and 21. 14, 21. From 6, 42. From 14, 42. And from 21, 42. That's it. So this is the diagram after removing reflexive and transitive edges. What examiner will think? You did this step first, and from this step, you actually removed reflexive and transitive edges and you got this. And from this, you placed in this shape, and from this, you got the diagram. But what we did in a reverse order. What we did after step number one, so let me write it down. You're going to write down the step number one first, then four, then three, and then two. And if you follow this trick, you can easily manage this particular, these type of examples. Trust me, friends, if you don't follow, you cannot get this. You cannot get this because it's very difficult or nearly impossible to remove all the transitive edges properly. And from that, you should get this properly. And after that, and it's very difficult. Is this clear? That is it. So if there is a divisibility problem, follow these steps and you can easily get it. Now, most of the students will be confused how to draw this directly. Don't worry, friends, in the next video, watch this video two, three times till the time you understood, you understand this. But if you don't understand, no problem, because in the next video, we'll be discussing five examples of divisibility in which we'll directly draw this. So don't waste much time behind understanding it. If you understood well and good, 60-70% understanding is also enough. Go to the next video and watch how we draw the draw their phi diagram. Okay, that's it for this video. Hope you understood. Thank you.